Marjorie Taylor Greene claims that she was attacked by a wild woman. And we're looking at her with the side eye. Let's put up the tweet. Quite interesting. So Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene, a known Karen, as a matter of fact, she is in the history books as the first Karen elected to the US Congress, claims that she was accosted by an insane woman and her adult son. This was at a restaurant. While she didn't say where the incident allegedly took place, she claimed to be a victim of political intolerance by the left. Now, this is quite fascinating, is it not? She gets to literally say on national news that states should divorce other states because of their political position, their political point of view. We literally need to engage in a civil war type separation because of this political dissension that has always been. Political differences have always been here. But she says, no. They were intolerant of me. The same woman who yelled, heckled the president of the United States during the State of the Union in an outfit that was comparable to her actual congressional representation. There's more. Greene, who last week called for a national divorce between red states and blue states, claimed the woman's son screamed at her, and she lamented the lack of civility between those with differing political views. People used to respect others, even if they had different views, she said. But not anymore. Our country is gone. Ladies and gentlemen, I do have to pause on this point and say to you, this right here, if you ever need an example of white privilege, boom, here it is. She literally is the person she's talking about. She's the individual who lacks civility. She's the person who continues to violate the congressional rules she signed to follow. She's the person who heckled the president of the United States during the State of the Union. She's the individual who actually said that we are likely headed to a civil war because of left-wing policies and them pushing their left-wing agenda. That's what she said. Greene, for her part, once called for the execution also of who? Former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. And a move that got her expelled from her committee assignments in the previous Congress before they were restored by the current Speaker Kevin No Backbone McCarthy. Now, she had an opportunity to actually try to clarify what she meant when she said we need to divorce from state to state. First of all, no idea how that works, especially with purple states and states that, like Georgia, that have two US senators who are Democrats. So you have no federal representation if you take your Democrats away. And you have other statewide positions that are Republican. What do you do in that scenario? And also, 8 out of the 9 poorest states in the country are Republican states. They cannot sustain themselves without federal dollars. Their state budget does not make enough, Mississippi being primary. But here's what she said when given the opportunity to actually clear it up. Here it is.
In my life, in my world, all of my friends are regular Americans. Everyone I talk to is sick and tired and fed up of being bullied by the left, abused by the left, and disrespected by the left. And our ideas, our policies, our ways of life have become so far apart that it's just coming to that point. And the last thing I ever want to see in America is a civil war. No one wants that. At least everyone I know would never want that. But it's going that direction, and we have to do something about it.
Let me go ahead and give you some of the code words so you can pick up on it every time it's said. Number one, regular Americans, white bigoted people. Number two, disrespected by the left, That simply means the left has pushed back on an agenda item that they would like to push down the throats of most Americans, even though most Americans are antithetical to the position of the Republican Party on most items. Number three, our policies and our way of life. Who are they talking about? They're talking about a particular group, a particular identity. They're not talking about the diversity of America. They're talking about the non-diversity of America. You see, this is when they reveal to you what they meant by make America great again. This is the great revelation of that proclamation they never could answer during Trump's actual administration. They are now giving you the rest of the story. Sharon, thoughts here?
Dr. Richey, when your breath stinks, you're the last one to smell it. Okay, when you're intoxicated, you don't know it. You don't know it. You're the last person. They got to say, you're drunk. Sit down. Yeah. Okay. And, you know, when you are a Karen, the mirrors in your home look like you stole them out of a fun house. Very distorted view. I was going to get on here and fake the funk. You know, I heard there's this show in the morning that sometimes I watch. It has these ladies who they laugh, they cackle a lot, and they discuss the issues of the day. And they, well, she should get empathy to show her this is what we're capable. Wrap your arms around her, love her. That's not me. Yeah. This is great if it's true, because she does not always tell the truth. If this happened, it's great. She needs a wake up call that looks like, I don't know, reality. So it's fantastic.
Yeah. I don't think it actually happened. I think she made the whole thing up. But we shall see if somehow she produces maybe at least a location. All right.